My name is Dr. Martin Austwick, and I'm a laser physicist at the National Medical Laser Centre, which is part of UCL, but we have very strong links with University College Hospital and the Royal Free Hospital up in Hampstead. The Laser Centre, as you might guess, started out to research lasers in medicine, but in recent years it's sort of broadened out to cover the use of light and other minimally invasive techniques for detection and treatment of disease. And one of the things we're pretty well known for is photodynamic therapy, which is this technique which has three components. It uses light, it uses a particular kind of drug, and it uses oxygen in the body together to create a therapeutic effect. I always think of this as a sort of a technique which uses three boring things to get somewhere interesting, because on their own, each of these techniques, each of these elements doesn't do anything. So the light itself is typically we use a laser, but it's not very powerful. It's not the sort of intense beam that would give you a burn if you shone it on yourself. So on its own, it doesn't really do very much. The next component we use is the drug. We use drugs called photosensitizers. And these are drugs which on their own, they don't do very much at all. If you took them, they would just pass through your body and not really have any effect. But when you shine a light on them, for example, the laser light that we use, they get activated. And they become a more reactive form of themselves, and they can start to interact with the chemicals around them. Now, this sounds sort of like slightly magical and science fiction-y, but actually these chemicals are really, really common. If you look at plants, chlorophyll does exactly that. In the process of photosynthesis, it takes energy from the sun, takes light from the sun, and it converts it into a sort of chain of chemical reactions which moves energy and chemicals around the plant. So we take these photosensitive chemicals, photosensitizer chemicals. They become activated by the light, and then in the body you tend to have a lot of oxygen around the place. Almost throughout the entire body you'll find oxygen, because cells need it to survive and to respire. And under normal circumstances, this oxygen doesn't do very much. It just helps the body keep on going. It doesn't have any therapeutic or dramatic effect. But when you combine it with this activated chemical, it can produce reactive oxygen species, we call them. So just different types of reactive oxygen. And these reactive oxygen species, they will move around from the site that they were created and start to bash into cells, into living structures, and have a chemical reaction and actually start to damage them. So it's a little bit like having a very, very small sort of microscopic chemical burn. We're producing the sort of chemical burn at the site by this photodynamic effect. You might very reasonably say, well, why do you want to do this? Like, why are we trying to burn tissue? Well, obviously, normal tissue, there's no reason to want to do that. But if you've got tissue which is unhealthy, for example, you've got a benign tumour, or you've got cancer, or something which might lead to cancer, and you want to kill it before it gets to that stage, this is the sort of technique that you'd want to use. So the way that this works in practice is you bring your patient in, and this is our patient. Patient's full of oxygen because they just naturally are full of oxygen from breathing, and you give them a photosensitizer. And what you generally do is you give it to them what we say systemically, so you inject it, or they take it by mouth. And so this little bit of chemical goes through their whole body, and as their heart pumps the blood around their body, this chemical will get forced around the body and it will go into all of the different organs in the skin, all of the different parts of the body. And now at this point, the patient is going to have this photosensitizer throughout their body, and so any part of their body that you shine a light on, if it's an intense enough light, will cause this chemical burn. So if this patient went out on a bright sunny day like this, they'd get a nasty skin burn. So you have to keep them out of the light. In this case, we're going to cover them up. But in general, you don't need to put a handkerchief over a patient's head. You can keep them in a dimly lit hospital room, and the light levels in a dimly lit room are fine. So at this point, you have to leave the patient for a little while. You have to make sure the drug is where you want it to be and in the concentrations that you need for the treatment. And so you leave them for a little while, depending on the drug, and you come back, and hopefully the drug's got everywhere. So then you take them into clinic, and let's say this chap has got something on his back that you want to treat. You take your laser, and you just shine it on the little region that you want to treat. So if we shine it here, hopefully you can see that there's just a little bit of a region of treatment around that part of his back. And that means just that part of the patient will be irradiated and will have that chemical burn, and if there's a lesion there, it will get damaged and shrunk down and killed off, hopefully. So there's the two very obvious advantages of this this treatment. The first one is it's very targeted. If you know what you want to treat, you can just focus in on that and you can just treat that. And the other one is to do with the way that photodynamic therapy, it tends to kill living cells only. Now, I'm a physicist, so my sort of primitive understanding of tissue physiology is that what you have is a sort of matrix of proteins, which are somewhat inert, things like collagen, which give the organs of your tissue structure and shape. And then in that matrix, in between the little gaps, are little living cells which actually respire and do the business of living. Now, traditional treatments, like old-fashioned laser treatments, where you're using an intense beam of laser light, or surgery where you're using a cutting device, are kind of breaking these matrices apart. They're breaking apart the scaffolding of the tissue. And that means when they heal up afterwards, you get scarring and you get disfigurement and these sorts of issues. With photodynamic therapy, what tends to happen is you're targeting the living cells and not the matrix, and the matrix tends to stay intact, which means that when you kill off your naughty cells, whatever they may be, they die off. Sometime later, those gaps will be repopulated by healthy normal cells, but the structure, the matrix, will have been kept intact. So you won't get the same degree of damage or disfigurement to the organ. And if it's something visible, if it's something on the skin or on the face, for example, that's really, really important for the patient. So photodynamic therapy, it's applicable in a whole range of different organs, and we're investigating that as we speak. It's already been proven effective in a number of those organs. And it has, in many cases, it has this very, very positive cosmetic effect after treatment. So it's something we're really excited about.